Hi guys. Selection of rootstocks for almond varieties is a controversial issue. It is at least as significant as choosing varieties. If you misselect a variety for your orchard, you can graft the correct cultivars onto the same rootstocks and convert the variety with time. In such a case, you can take advantage of the well-developed roots. On the other hand, in case you do not choose the correct rootstocks, there might be no option but replanting. Before deciding rootstocks, soil and nematode analysis should be made. Soil structure, mineral content, salinity pH, lime ratio, and water permeability are the important components in soil analysis. The amount of the nematodes in the soil should also be determined. As for rootstocks, the preference between almond seedlings and clonal rootstocks obtained by tissue culture is open to discussion. Almond seedlings, or the almond trees grafted on bitter almond, have lifelong trees. They can grow for decades. However, these rootstocks do not fructify early and the trees may not behave consistently and uniformly. Clonal rootstocks, on the other hand, are obtained from a plant that is free from diseases and has the best genes with tissue culture, and all the trees in the orchard perform the same or similar behavior. Clonal rootstocks allow trees to fructify early and to yield consistent crops. In almond seedlings, it is very difficult to know how strong genes your rootstocks have. With a tissue culture method, different rootstocks able to resist or tolerate various problems and difficulties can be produced. Among almond seedlings, bitter almond is drought resistant. It makes long life trees. Accordingly, trees grow very large, resistant to boron and lime. However, they are not suitable for heavy soils holding water. They are also very sensitive to nematodes. The almond trees grafted on bitter almonds should be planted in high spacing. GF677 is an almond peach hybrid rootstock resistant to drought and tolerates calcareous soils. It is not suitable for heavy soils having bad drainage. It makes trees fructified early. GF677 is an ideal rootstock for rain-fed orchards, but it is very sensitive to root knot nematodes. Garnem is a water-loving rootstock, ideal for heavy clay soils having bad drainage. It should not be preferred for rain-fed orchards. It is resistant to root knot nematodes. It makes 10% larger trees than GF677. It constantly creates its own sucker shoots from the bottom, which requires extra pruning workforce. As it sprouts earlier than GF677, it is not an ideal rootstock for the regions having risk of spring frost. Since we have nematodes in our lands, we had to choose Garnem. I believe that Garnem rootstock also gave us an advantage in flood disasters we experienced 3 times last year. With GF677, the damage could be much worse. The new generation productive almond varieties such as Penta, Vairo, Marinada, and Macaco should be irrigated well in order to take advantage of their productivity features. In other words, it is not a good idea to plant these cultivars in rain-fed orchards. Therefore, it is not directly based on scientific data, but I can infer that Garnem can be a better complement than GF677 for productive almond varieties because it gets along with water better than GF677 or bitter almonds. The Spanish origin company Agromilera is currently leading the sector in the dwarf rootstock production for almonds. Among its almond compatible rootstocks, Rootpack 20 is full dwarf and Rootpack 40 is dwarf. They both are bred for super intensive orchards. These rootstocks are not ideal for rain-fed plantation, but both of them, particularly Rootpack 20, are resistant to root knot and lesion nematodes. Super intensive spacing makes possible to manage very large lands with minimum workmanship. According to the data provided by Agromilera, super intensive orchards reach full productivity within the following 3-4 years after plantation. However, the investment cost of such orchards is much higher. The number of saplings to be planted per unit area is greater than those grafted on the other rootstocks, and unfortunately the cost of unit sapling is not cheaper. The machines designed for pruning and harvesting are quite expensive and not common in our country. Thank you for watching and make sure you have subscribed my channel. Be safe and bye. Hoşça kalın. Adios.